In today's video, we're going to take a look at what's new with the Maps app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Basically, we have a new library where we can find all of our pinned locations or saved locations or even routes that we've created, which is also new. We can search for hiking trails near us. And we also have a new search here, which helps us when we move the map, we're looking for something and we move the map. What we can do is we can have the Maps app update with our search results. Let's see what I mean. Let's take a look at what's new with the Maps app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at the Maps app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Let's go over to my iPad. So I'm on an iPad. It's an iPad Pro. Not that that really matters, but it's an iPad Pro, and it is running iPadOS 18. Let's go ahead and open up the Maps app. I tap on it. So we're looking at the Maps app here, and basically what Apple changed, or the interface, what they changed in the interface, is they split it into two. It's really not split into two. This card actually floats up and down. But basically what we have here is we have this card, and then we have the map over here. Basically, what we're going to be looking at for the most part is this card over here. So what is new? Well, this card kind of incorporates everything. So we can see that we have the places that I've recently looked up. I can also see different guides that I've loved. So everything is located under this card. In addition to that, what we have is we have a new library. This is all new. And this library can include places that we've saved, as well as guides that we've saved, and even routes that we've created, which is also new in iPadOS 18. We can actually create routes, great for runners or walkers. Let's go ahead and take a look at this library. To do that, what we do is we just tap on this text here. So I'm going to tap on it. And now we're looking at my library. So we can see that we basically have four different categories here: pinned, places, guides, and then routes. Those are routes that I've created. More on that in a little bit. So if I wanted to see all my pinned locations, I just tap on pinned, and I can see all of my pinned locations. I want to add a new location, I can tap on add, and it'll add that location. To go back, we just tap on the X. So you can see that it's pretty easy to maneuver around now the new Maps app. Let's take a look at places. I tap on places, and now I'm looking at all these different places. I want to add one of these places to my pin. I'll show you where we can easily find these pins in a little bit. So what I'm going to do is go over to Professor Pizza here, and when I tap on the three dots, what I'm able to do is pin this. And when I pin it, it's going to show up under pinned. Also, it's going to show up on the main card. Let's go ahead and pin this. So I tap on it, and now it is pinned. So let's go ahead and close this, tap on the X. And now you're going to see when I go over to pinned here, that pizza place is going to show. In addition to that, though, pinned locations also show up on the main card. So I'm just going to close the library. I'm just going to tap on the X here to close this library. And when I do, you're going to see that I have my pin locations. The more pins you add, what you can do is you can just swipe over to the left or right. So your pinned locations can be easily accessible right from the main card here when you're looking at your library. In addition to that, what we're also able to do is add notes. So let's go over to the Professor Pizza here. I tap on it. And what I would like to do is I would like to add a note. To do that, we tap on more here. And when I do, I'm able to add a note. When I add a note in here, it does sync across different devices. So if I'm using the Maps app with iOS 18 or macOS Sequoia, I would see the same note. So let's just go with Great Vibe. I tap on Done, and now that note is in there. So where can I find that note? Well, when we're actually looking at the location, you're going to see it is right there, front and center. So we can easily see our notes. I can also add a note. I'm going to tap on the X over here to close this. I can also add a note when I'm looking at all the different locations. So let's just go over to my library here. And when I tap on the three dots over here, what I'm able to do is add a note. So there's a couple different places we can add a note. If there was a note attached here, I'd also be able to edit that note. So that's how we can add notes. So we have our pinned locations here. I also have places. So these are recent places that I've searched. So there's 15 places there. And of course, I can go and pin those or add a note to those if I wanted to. Let's go back. I can view different guides that I've saved. Guides are nothing new. They've been in the Maps app for a long time. But what I'm able to do is easily find all the guides just by tapping on this. And I can go and find all the guides that I've saved. Tap on X to close this. And then we have routes. Now this is new in iPadOS 18, as well as iOS 18 and macOS Sequoia. So if you're a runner or a hiker or maybe just a walker, you want to create a route. You can now create a route and it'll tell you the elevation as well as the length of that route. So let's see how this works. So what we're going to do is we're just going to go across the lake here. We're going to swim across the lake and we're going to go to where I live here. And we have a beautiful state park here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a route in that state park. Maybe I want to go walking. So usually what I will do is I will park in the parking lot here. And what we're going to do is we're just going to create a route that kind of goes out like that. So how do we do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go to create a route. So I need to tap on my library here. So I tap on it. And then we go over to routes. You're going to see that I have one route in there, but let's go ahead and add another one. So I tap on create. And now all I need to do is just drop a pin where I start and then drop pins where I want to walk. And what will happen is the Maps app will kind of follow the walking route and create a route for you. So it's not going to allow you to cut through a dune. These are dunes over here. We have a lot of dunes over here. So it's not going to allow you to cut through a dune. You have to follow a path, a hiking path, sidewalk, or something like that. So what I need to do is I need to start a route where I park, which is right over here. So basically I just tap there. And there's my route. That's the start. So now where do I want to go from here? Well, I'm going to go over to the general store. Maybe I'll grab an ice cream cone. So I tap on the general store close to it, and you can see that it created that route for me, and it's following a path. Let's just keep going. We're going to go over to the reservoir over here. This is another restaurant, so I tap on that, and you can see it is going up there. So let's just keep going up. This time what I'm going to do is I'm going to tap in this area here. And you're going to see that it's just going to kind of follow this route like that. So let's go ahead and tap in that area there. And you can see it followed it. And I can see how long that route is as well as the elevation. Now when you are done, we have a few different options. I can mark this as an out and back, which means I go out and then back. I can close the loop, so it's just a loop, or I can reverse it. So how do we close it? Well, basically, we just go back to our beginning point here. I'm going to tap on that. And then you're going to see I can close the loop, make it an out and back, or reverse the route. So let's just go with an out and back. I don't think I'll be able to walk across the water. There's no public paths to the water, so I just have to make this an out and back. So now I just tap on out and back, and when I do, it just created an out and back, and now we can see instead of 1.7 miles, it is 3.4 miles. So there's my path. So now all I need to do is I just need to save this, and when I do, it's going to save it to my routes. I can name this. I'm just going to leave it at Ottawa Beach Road. I can download the route, which might be good in this case here because the cell connection at the state park is kind of sketchy. If they're really busy, I have a poor signal. So what I'd be able to do is download this once I save this, and then I will not need a cell connection to kind of follow it along. So I tap on done up here to save it, and now it is saving that. You can see that it is downloading this. If I want to walk the route, I just tap on directions here, and I can find all of the routes. Let's go ahead and tap on the X here. In my library. So I tap on the X and we're looking at my routes here. You can see I have two routes there. Of course, they do sync across my different devices and they're going to be located in my library here. So that's how we work with our routes. In addition to that, if you want to walk a local hiking path, you can search hiking paths as well. So you don't have to create your own route. So I'm going to tap on the X here, and I'm just going to search for hiking. So I just type into this area here, hiking. And you're going to see it says hiking trails nearby. So now when I tap on that, it's going to look for all of the hiking trails that are nearby. And when I tap on them, let's go ahead and take a look at Stuyvesant Trails. When I tap on it, I'm going to get more information. I can download it. I can view the website. I can go and create a custom route for this. I can view photos. And I can see the rating of it. I swipe up. I also have a phone number as well as a website and its location. And if there's an issue, you can also report an issue there and I can go and pin it. So if I like this route, what I would do is I would pin it. And now, when we go back over to my main map here, you're going to see that I have, when I swipe over, Stuyvesant here. So I can easily just go to that trail and walk it just by tapping on that. The last thing I want to show you is search here. In the past, with the Maps app, when you search for something, let's go ahead and search for pizza. So I'm going to tap in here, and we're going to go with pizza. And then what you do is you just search nearby. And what it's going to do is it's going to use this location here to search for pizza. So I tap on it, and now it's showing me all the pizzas. Now, it can see that it zoomed in there a little bit. So I want to see the pizza places that are in Grand Rapids. What do I do? Well, all I have to do is just drag this map over. But in the past, when I did that, in a lot of cases, the Maps app would not update. You're going to see that it is updating. You're going to see all these little pizza joints in here. So I can zoom around here and look for all the different locations there. But in some cases, it wouldn't do that. And when I pinch and zoom and locate, you're going to see I have a new button here, search here. So if it doesn't update, this is not a full update. I know there's more pizza joints over in Grand Rapids. So what I'm able to do is tap on that search here, and now it's going to do a new search and show me all of the pizza places in Grand Rapids. So it's going to be based on where this map is. It should update automatically, and it does a pretty good job of that. But the nice thing is if it doesn't, you can tap on that search here button. So that is what is new with the Maps app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. And of course, this also works across all your different devices as long as you're using iOS 18 on the iPhone and macOS Sequoia on the Mac. So we have a new library where we have all of our different places that we've saved or pinned. We can create routes. We can search for hiking trails. And we have a new search here button when the search isn't updated. So that's the new Maps app, or what's new with the Maps app on the iPad with iPadOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. Also, what you may want to do is check out danstutorials.com. That's how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. Danstutorials.com is a membership-based site. You can view the videos, but I do include ads on the videos, much like YouTube. Or actually, they are YouTube ads. But when you become a member of my site, I take out all of those ads. Also, you have access to an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and you have access to my online classes and webinars, which I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. I'm not part of some large organization or anything like that. I'm in a corner office of my house, just a spare bedroom that I turned into a studio. And when you become a member, you're directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.